guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today what we're going to be doing is a makeup tutorial, and I know that I've been gone for a hot minute, like a week or so. I did kind of take a little bit of a break from filming. Every day off that I have from working my regular job, I'm always filming or doing makeup looks and stuff, and lately I've just kind of been like, I wanted to just have a day to do nothing, and it was my friend's birthday, and we like celebrated all day, so it's been a little bit since I've been filming, but I did come back with, this fall makeup tutorial for you guys. Very like warm eyes. It's kind of like a smoky eye, but I do have the duochrome shadows on my lids from Makeup Geek. I don't know if you guys got your hands on any of those, but seriously, they are so gorgeous. I love their foiled shadows, and this is a super similar formula, except these do have a little bit of fallout, which is okay. Obviously, just clean that up. That's the only difference between these ones and the foiled ones. I do love them. And they obviously are so gorgeous on the eyes. And they're $6, I think. So if you guys want to pick them up, I will have links down below where you can get all of them if you want. God, so the other day I was YouTubing how to get a bigger ass. Because with the Halloween costume that I want to do, except I don't know what I want to do. But I know that I want to, like, have a bigger butt. So I was, like, YouTubing, like, little exercise you can do, and oh my god, like, I am so sore. Like, my, like, hips and butt are, like, aching, so it was sitting through this whole entire tutorial was so difficult because I am so, so sore in my legs, but that is all that I had to say about that. If you guys want to see how to achieve this fall look, then just keep watching. So, we're first going in with the Morphe Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm going in with this super orange shade at the top. It doesn't have a name, so I'm just going to kind of describe it. And we're using a MAC 229 brush. This is going to be our transition shade because this is going to be such a warm eye. Peach Smoothie wasn't warm enough, so that's why I chose this one instead. So I'm just back and forth in the crease, and now we're going in with this warmer shade. It's a little bit darker than the other one. And we're using a MAC 217 brush, and we're focusing this in the low crease area. So this is going to help with the depth, but it's also going to help with blending out the darker shade that we're going to be applying on the lid later on. I like to apply a little bit of a darker shade before, so it's not like so much work to be blending it out afterwards. And I'm just taking that from inner to outer corner, making sure that the color is like evenly distributed. And this brush is perfect because it helps you get into like those small, like hard to reach places. Sound like an old woman. Alright, so now we're going into my favorite shade. This is the new Makeup Geek Duochrome Shadows, and this one is in Steampunk. So this one is like a black brown that reflects like gold, not gold, but it reflects like this burnt orange shade. It's like beautiful. So I thought that this would be absolutely stunning for a fall look, and I'm just applying this with that Urban Decay brush that can just pack the shades on. The only problems with these shadows are they do have a little bit of fallout, but obviously you can clean those up. And I'm just taking the 217 and going through the crease. Now we're spraying the brush and packing more on because I want it to be super metallic and super, like, dramatic. Obviously, look at me. So that's what we did there. And now we're taking this small brush and a little bit of Corrupt right where the lid shadow meets the crease, just so it blends it out and it just gives a little bit more depth and it makes your eyes look a little bit more smoky. Now taking the Benefit Roller Lash, and we're just applying some mascara before we apply our false lashes. And I like to just do, like, a generous coat. I want to make sure all that my lashes are covered, because if not, then you can kind of see them when you apply the black false lashes, and that's just not a cute look. So now onto my favorite drugstore lashes. I don't know if you guys have tried this brand. It's called Eylure. They're the brand that came out with the Vegas Nay lashes, and these are like my favorite drugstore. Like, everyone's all about Ardell, and I just think these are so much better. Like, I get so many more uses out of them, and they look so much more like high quality. Like, they look like velour lashes, and I pay like $7 for them. So I'm just taking my tweezers and setting these in. You guys know how to do that. And then I pinch my lashes with the fake lashes, so then you can't really see where they end. Don't want y'all to have a heart attack, but I actually filmed me doing my foundation. So I'm just applying the Makeup Forever Step 1 Equalizer in Smoothing and the Becca Ever Matte Poreless Perfecting Primer. Yeah, that's a mouthful. So I'm just applying that in my T-zone, everywhere you would normally prime. And then I'm going in with the Too Faced Born This Way Foundation. I'm literally running out, and this is my favorite foundation. I know that it looks a little bit
like warmer on camera, but I swear to God, it matches me so perfectly. And something else different for today, I'm not applying this with a beauty blender today. Like, I'm going in with my Sigma F80 Flat Top Kabuki. I'm bringing this bad boy back out. Favorite one of all time to apply foundation. I will leave a link down below where you can get all of these brushes from, and also a discount code, which will be listed down below, like per usual, if you guys want to pick up any of these brushes. So I'm just kind of packing this. As you guys see, I'm patting and I'm not like rubbing it in, because then you're just going to kind of move the product all around. I want this to absorb right into my skin, so I'm just pushing it in so that my skin absorbs the product and makes it lay super nicely and looks flawless, and you can't really detect that you're wearing it. So I'm just kind of going around and making sure everything is up to like the coverage that I want it to be. And then you're going to be looking flawless as ever. But yeah, this is my favorite brush of all time. And now look at these goddamn dark circles. So I'm taking the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in Custard. And I'm just applying this a little bit under my eyes. I used to apply so much more than this, but I like this technique a little bit better, where I just draw like 4 to 5 lines. And I feel like that helps me with not using too much product. It kind of is just like just enough, and I don't end up going like overboard and wasting. So now I'm going to use the Sigma, I don't even know what this brush is called. It's the HD Concealer brush, and I'm using this to blend out the concealer everywhere. Once again, like, I'll leave the places where you can get all these brushes down below, but I really truly love the way that this looks and the way that this blends out. Like, nothing's gonna beat a beauty blender, like, to be honest. Like, it's just my favorite way. But at least, like, when that's dirty or when I just don't feel like using it, I can use a brush, because I don't want it to be streaky. Nobody wants it to be streaky. So we're just blending this out and making sure that there's no harsh lines, and it kind of all just blends seamlessly and looks absolutely flawless. I'm excited for this part every single time, and that is when I'm setting and baking my concealer. I'm using the CoverGirl Translucent Powder, and I'm using a totally different beauty blender than I normally would. This is just a dry one that I use strictly for powder, and I'm setting my under eyes. I'm actually like packing the powder quite heavily underneath both eyes, and then I do it on my chin, on my nose, and then in the center of my forehead. It just kind of helps me stay pretty matte throughout the day, and it really helps my foundation last a lot longer than normal because I am so oily. So if you're oily, definitely try this technique out. And now I'm just taking a little bit of powder on this fluffy brush and setting the areas where I'm not baking, because you want to make sure the foundation is set. And now we're just dusting this powder away, and as you guys see, like, it just looks so smooth, and I think that that's what I love so much about it, because I used to have problems with my under eyes like caking, and I don't anymore because this powder kind of just like makes it look flawless, which I'm like in love with, obviously. And now we're going to contour, and we're using the Anastasia Contour Kit, the powder one, and I'm using the shades Fawn and Java, but I'll list everything down below if that's incorrect. And I'm just taking this outer perimeters of the face, under the cheekbones. I'm contouring this damn forehead, because when I wear my hair up, like, I have a 5 head. I'm like, why do I have such a big ass forehead? And now we're going to be taking this powder again, and I love carving out my contour. I think that this just makes any look put together. It just makes my contour look super clean, and it just covers a little bit of my redness too, because I still have some that peeks through, but once I bake, it like is perfect and you can never see any of it. So now we're taking MAC Blush in Breezy and this stippling brush. Like I said, favorite way to apply this blush because it is so pigmented. I don't want to look like a clown, so I like that this just kind of disperses the product like evenly and like nicely over my cheeks, and it looks gorgeous. And now we're taking my favorite highlight of the moment, and this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills in Riviera. And as you see, I've already like dove in, and I'm taking the Sigma F41 fan brush, which they do sell separately on their website. And look at this goddamn highlight. Like, oh, Anastasia and Norvina, you're obviously killing the game. I'm so obsessed. In your lip glosses, gorgeous. So I'm just applying this high points of the cheek, and I'm applying this on my nose and a little bit down the bridge just to make me glow for the damn gods. And now I'm taking Corrupt and a Sigma E21 brush, and I'm just kind of smoking out my lower lash line. I feel like this is a necessary step for any single makeup look. I don't care if it's natural, dramatic, anything. This just really ties the whole entire look together. And I don't apply anything in my waterline because my eyes do water so much. So if I apply anything in my waterline, it like just transfers anyway. So I like to apply everything on my lower lash line, so it just smokes everything out and it just pulls the look together. So I'm just blending this out with this brush, as you see right here, and a little bit of creme brulee, and I'm just looking straight up, and I really take a little bit of time blending this because I want to make sure that it's seamless. I don't want it to be harsh or anything. I want it to be smoky because this is smoky and dramatic, obviously. And now we're taking my favorite drugstore mascara, and this is Maybelline Big Eyes. And I just like the other end, so it comes with like a regular mascara end and like a small mascara end, but this is my favorite mascara for lower lashes. Like, I have a problem where my lower lashes get like super like clumpy. I don't know why, but this just separates them and makes them look so gorgeous and long. And ugh, like if you guys are ever in the drugstore, pick this up and you will not regret it. So now we're just dusting away our baking technique, and then we're going to be on to the lips. And I'm applying MAC lipstick in Honey Love. So as you guys see, it's kind of like a really warm nude lipstick, and I didn't really like love that at first. I didn't really notice how warm it was. But I apply a gloss over it anyway. But this is my favorite nude lip. It's literally like concealer over the lips. And then I'll apply MAC gloss in, I'm not even sure what the gloss is called, but I will leave it down below. And that just has a little bit of pink in it, so it takes away this like oranginess of the warm lipstick. You guys know what I'm talking about. And yeah, that's the completed look. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I love you guys, and I will see you guys all in my next one.
Watching. I hope you enjoyed that tutorial, and I will be doing a couple more fall looks and a couple Halloween looks. I didn't pre-record any like other YouTubers did, which, oh, good for them, because I just couldn't do it. Plus, I haven't really done many like crazy Halloween looks. I'm more of like a beauty makeup kind of person, but like I do like doing like Halloween looks. So if you guys have any like specific tutorials that you guys want to see Halloween wise, let me know down in the comments so I can start filming those, because those are going to take a little bit longer to film and edit, obviously, than just a regular beauty video. So don't forget to subscribe. The button is down there somewhere, and like the video if you guys are all about fall makeup tutorials. Obviously I am. And let me know if you guys picked up any of the Makeup Geek duochrome shadows. Let me know the ones that you guys picked up or what your favorites are, and maybe I'll do a tutorial with some of your guys' favorites. Maybe we have the same favorites, because I already have like my staple couple that I'm like, oh, I love. I'll be using this probably in every single makeup look. So yeah, so thank you guys for watching. I don't want to ramble on too much longer because I feel like this video is long enough, and yeah, I will see you guys all in my next one.